Today I'm showing how I edit my food videos that inspire folks to get cooking in the kitchen. People love food. So naturally, people love food videos. Now, even if you can't cook, there's just something about a well-shot and edited food video that makes us all stare and salivate if done right. This is a short recipe video I shot and edited for Instagram. So watch it and then I'll show you how I did it. While the method you choose to shoot a food video is important, it all really comes to life in the editing process. I've been using Adobe Premiere Pro to edit all of my videos for years, whether I was at home on a desktop computer or traveling the world and using my laptop. It has everything I need built right into the platform. And I'm really excited to show you a new feature called the Scene Edit Detection Tool, which lets you bring in footage and it'll automatically detect the original cut points in your video. That's what I used to edit this one. I took an old food video I shot and needed to be updated with color correction and graphics to narrate the story. It was a really rough cut. So I imported this file and used the Scene Edit Detection Tool to automatically chop up the video at all of the original cut points. So I could go back in and color correct each individual scene, giving the video a second chance at life by transforming it from rough cut into a beautiful finished piece that I could upload to Instagram. So here's a step-by-step tutorial on how I put this food video together. Let's dive right in. So first, I'm going to launch Adobe Premiere Pro and create a new project. I'm going to name my file Vegan Chocolate Cake. Once inside Premiere, I'm going to right-click and create some bins, one for my sequence and one for my video clips. Now I'm right-clicking in my video folder and importing my video footage. I'm going to select the file with the old clip strung together and drag it to the timeline. This will create a new sequence, which I'll store in my sequence folder to stay organized. Before I start editing, I need to change the dimensions of the video so that it's vertical for Instagram. So I right-click on the sequence and select the sequence settings. Here I adjust the frame size to 1080 by 1350. Now, as you can see, it's vertical instead of horizontal, which is the perfect size for Instagram. But now the shots look super zoomed in, so we need to scale it down so that it fits the new frame size. One effect that's a real time saver is the auto reframe effect. So let's go into our effects tab and do a search for auto reframe. And there it is. The auto reframe effect is located under video effects in the transform folder. Let's apply that effect to our video clip, and boom. Just like that, it automatically reframed the video so that all the shots fit beautifully into the frame. Now as I scrub through, you can see this video I edited needs some work. Some clips are too dark, some are too light, and the overall edit is way too long. It needs to be cut down to under a minute for Instagram. In order to color correct each individual scene, I need to chop this up at all the edit points. To save time, I'm going to right-click on my clip and select the Scene Edit Detection Tool. I'm going to apply a cut at each detected cut point. And then I'm going to check this box to also create a bin of subclips from each detected cut point and hit Analyze. Premiere is analyzing the clips to detect where all the jump cuts are so that it can automatically chop up my video at those points. And voila, it chopped it up perfectly. With it chopped up like this, I can go into each individual scene and color correct as needed. Now, when editing a food video, the first step I like to take is importing the music. So I'm going to create a new bin, name it audio, right-click, and import my music track. Let's double-click and play it to give it a listen. Yeah, nice. I like it. So then I'm going to drag the audio clip down to the timeline. Next, let's work on editing the music track. I'm going to give it a listen to see if it needs to be trimmed down. Yeah, we don't need those extra beats, so I'm trimming it. I just want a couple seconds of intro music before the main beat drops. The intro part is where you'll put your beauty shots, and when the beat drops, that's when you want your recipe instructions to start. So I'm moving the start of the recipes to the exact moment when the beat drops, right here. And I have roughly 3 seconds before that to show some beauty shots of the food. You always want to start your food video off with beauty shots of the finished dish to give your viewers a preview of what it is you're about to make. So I'm going to pick a couple of close-ups and maybe a medium shot of the finished cake and drop that down into my timeline. Now let's play it and see how it flows. Perfect. Now we need to cut this video down to under a minute for Instagram. To do this, go through all your recipe steps and trim them down to just the most important action of each step. So for these, I just want to show the ingredients going into the bowl. Another way to quicken the pace is to adjust the speed. So to make this clip go faster, for example, I'm doubling the speed from 100 to 200. And I'll continue adjusting the speed and/or trimming clips throughout the rest of the timeline until I get it down to under a minute. And voila, 44 seconds, perfect. The last big thing to add to your food video is text. You want to spell out for your viewers what the name of the ingredients are that you're showing in your recipe, and also the measurements if you want. So for that, we tap the Graphics tab, which brings us into the Essential Graphics panel. Adobe Premiere Pro conveniently has built-in graphics that you can tap into for your project so you never have to leave the program. So start by finding a nice graphic for the intro of your video. This is where you'll display the title of your dish so your viewers know the name of what it is you're making. When you find the one you want, drag it above your video track. And to edit the text, make sure it's highlighted and the text key is selected. Then make your changes. You can adjust the size of your text, the placement of your text. There are a ton of controls to play with. Next, you'll want to add the text for the ingredients. For these, just a basic title is sufficient. So I'll drag the basic title template over my first ingredient clip and edit it the same way I did my title. Then I'm going to copy this and paste it all throughout my timeline for the rest of the ingredients. And whenever I paste it, I just go in and edit the text. And I'll continue doing that for every recipe step. When I get to the step where I remove my pan off screen, I want to add an effect that makes it look like my text is being revealed as the pan is moving. For this, we go into the Effects tab and drag the wipe transition onto the beginning of the text. Then adjust the transition handles to the point where you want the text to finish revealing on screen. Play it back to see how it looks. And that's it. You're pretty much done. Save your work and then play your video from the beginning to make sure you like it. Let's see what mine looks like. And just like that, we have a food video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Between the essential graphics panel and the new scene edit detection tool, Premiere is hands down the most efficient editing software for creating the kind of videos you want to put out into the world. Now, if you enjoy this video, make sure you give it a huge thumbs up, comment with any questions you have, and subscribe for more tech and food videos headed your way. Thanks for watching, and until next time, stay green, y'all.